Yeah. Did you ever play basketball growing up?
Oh, so I actually didn't play basketball, and I actually never thought I would play 2K because I never understood it. But once I finally played against somebody, that's when it got a little more fun for me.
2K Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
Hey everybody, we're coming to you live on 2K Sports, bringing you the NBA. Welcome everyone, courtside with two ex-NBA stars, Grant Hill and Brent Berry. I'm Brian Anderson. We've got Ali LaForce on the sidelines tonight as well. We'll see the New York Knicks and the Toronto Raptors. It'll be the Knicks off the tip. Here's Ward, and here's the starting group for the New York Knicks. And he taps it home with authority.
The BA, when he gets the rim in his sights, it's tough to stop.
So aggressive and a determined finisher. Nice. And there it is for him.
The defensive effort was lacking a bit, but hey, give him credit for finding a weakness there.
Just really smart basketball and exploiting whatever holes that he's seeing right now in the defensive squad.
Here's Ward, pass to Johnson. Here's Sprewell. Off target from outside.
Hey, sometimes you miss even under the best of circumstances.
Carter from outside. Tipped away. Out of bounds. It'll be New York's ball.
Knicks ball.
Here's Ward. There's the double team with Carter. About a minute played here so far in the first. Ewing, no good. Here's Bogues. From behind the arc. And the ball out of play. The Knicks will have it. Here's Ward. And the layup is good off the glass.
And that's just nasty right there, guys. He has a tremendous crossover.
And that was the mobile one drive. Low resistance to the finish line.
You're toasting the defense and getting in close. They'll take possessions like that one all day.
I love this approach. Getting him involved early, and it's already paying off.
Well, he's going to just keep going now. That's early confidence for him.
Johnson with a bucket.
Attacking in the painted area. Clearly that was their game plan coming in.
To the inside. Davis can't hit.
Well, a lot of players in the league are going to make that shot, and for him, it's pretty much automatic. It's a good defensive effort to prevent the layup.
And the shot's good. Now Carter. Now, if you're just tuning in, we've played about 2.5 minutes here in the first. Oh, he nails that one. 3 for 4 now. Carter's gone 3 for 4 from the floor tonight. Pass to Ewing. Here's Ward. It's tipped. Here's Oakley. Toronto, the rebound. Taken away. Sprewell gets the bucket.
Sometimes it's simple. Put the ball in the hands of your scorers and let them do what they do best.
Carter from outside. And Ward pulls it down. The Knicks with the lead. Here's Sprewell. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Knicks.
They've done a great job establishing an inside presence. Now that'll open up more options offensively throughout the remainder of the game.
Well, not only that, but you love how unselfish they've been to start this game. That's going to get all the guys in a great flow and feeling good. So moving that ball around and scoring off assists, it's a nice way to play. Now that basket must be widening out right now, and he's making almost every shot he's putting up this quarter.
Time called here. The Knicks decide to talk it over.
And things are always changing throughout a game. Teams have to adjust on the fly.
And timeouts are a wonderful opportunity to just settle in and recollect the thoughts of your entire team. Not just the guys playing, but the entire team.
Here's Houston. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his first points of the game. Offensive board.
He's so good at getting to the rim. Maybe tries to get a little bit too cute with that one. I thought he'd lay it straight up and in.
Carter can't get it to go.
Yeah, and the defense has really got to tighten up on him. I mean, he's just too dangerous from the three-point line.
New York, no good that time either. Toronto trailing. Pass to Bogues. Here's Oakley. Outside Carter. Launches a three. Sends it home from three-point land. Carter's got 12 points.
And that's what they want to do. Get him open looks early.
Stolen by Carter. From downtown. Doesn't go that time. To the middle. Here's Ward. Ooh, the lead pass was in the perfect spot to set up the layup. He's got six.
Good execution. They're getting some short-range looks here.
And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two.
And good whistle there.
His first personal foul. First team foul. At the line for your Raptors. Vince Carter.
That one misses.
At the line for two.
That's off as well, so he misses both.
I love how they've attacked the boards here in the first quarter.
From the arc. The next rebound. Thomas, that's good.
Thomas.
Hey, they're just getting pushed around inside.
And here's Carter. 12 points for him. And that bucket makes him 6 for 10 in the contest.
It feels like the other four guys have disappeared at this point. He wants to be the one to get them back.
Sinks it again. That's his 7th made field goal in 11 tries.
The name of the game isn't scoring. It's scoring efficiency.
Pass to Houston. A rebound by Willis. So it's Toronto now. Here's Carter. And it's slammed in by Carter.
Earning his money on the interior tonight. That's a nice move.
New York trailing. Here's Houston. Here's Sprewell. Nails it from beyond the arc.
Pretty much not a player in the league is going to pass up a shot like that. So much for the defense.
Outside Carter. Beyond the arc. And it's Thomas with the rebound. Carter's gone just 2 of 7 from distance. Pass to Sprewell. Takes a three. They get it back. Thomas. And that one makes him 2 for 2. He's in his rhythm.
That's a testament to the effort there on the boards. Never willing to give up on the possession. Finding ways to sniff out the ball.
Carter can't get it to go. .141 left in the first quarter. Here's Camby. Checked by Davis. Floats one. Camby, that's good.
The player gets a feel for that floater. Can really make things tough on defenders. You're just not sure how to guard him and where your point of commitment is.
And the Raptors making a change here. Curry's checked in. There's Davis with the three. And they'll get another chance.
Oh my. What a display of effort.
That's his bread and butter, right? Chasing down the boards.
Stick with fundamentals there. Shot goes up, box out, or he'll destroy you.
Oh, nice shot by Brown.
He's going to punish you if you leave him open. He's more than willing to take the open three when he's got it.
From about 19, and it's New York scoring again. And here are the Raptors now, trailing by 2. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot 2.
That's his first personal foul.
He misses the free throw. Dudley, he's checked in for Thomas.
At the line for Toronto.
He hits the second from the line. ...50 seconds left to play in the first. Pass to Wingate. Rebound by the Raptors. Davis has got his fourth rebound in this one. And here's Brown for three. Here's Willis. And the rebound goes to the Knicks. 20 seconds left in the opening quarter. Here's Dudley. And another shot. Shoots over Davis. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
Dudley.
No good on that one. He does not get the second one. Outside, Brown. The three. Oh, no good on the last second attempt there. And at the end of one, both teams putting up some points. It's the Knicks leading by one. Stay with us now as we get set to bring you quarter number two after this. As we get back to a game that's been pretty close so far here. All right, before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen from the Knicks?
We all know good ball movement is what most coaches harp on, and their passing's been excellent so far.
Well, everybody just feeling the energy of the basketball as they moved it around, and lots of hands were touching it.
So here are the five from New York as they start the second.
And that really has to lift his teammates' spirits right now.
I'll tell you, Grant, these second-chance buckets could be what this game comes down to.
Well, especially in a close game, every possession matters.
Sprewell, no good. The Raptors with a lead. Pass to McGrady. Oh, and makes it with the kiss.
All the way to the bucket, no resistance. Just swipe the candy from him.
Here's Sprewell. 9 points in the game. Johnson controls the rebound and the putback.
Hard work creating the second chance opportunity.
Here's Curry. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
You know, that was an excellent play right there. Using his strength to power through contact.
All right, guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Raptors.
In the early goings, their effort level has been exceptional. The speeding around the defense and opening up options with good penetration.
And they've sort of assumed control of this game with their pressure defensively. They've been into the ball handler. They've done a great job of swarming, so they're creating some turnovers for their capitalizing.
And their offensive execution has really picked up here in the second period.
And that replay showed how sensational that drive truly was.
And I love the way he played downhill on that drive. Love the attack mentality in a close game.
Pass to Thomas. Toronto grabs the miss. They're dialed in offensively.
Sure are. Staying in attack mode and at the same time playing under control.
McGrady gets the three ball to go. And now it's an 8-point Toronto lead.
It took a little bit of time, but now he's taking the pen off the cap and putting his mark on this game.
Here's Ewing. Curry with a steal. Here's McGrady. 7 points in the game. His fourth make in five tries. Solid start for him.
McGee hasn't been quick enough to react to the ball inside. That's helped cause this run.
Outside Johnson. To end the run. And it's rejected. Pass to McGrady. From deep. And it's Thomas with the rebound. Thomas has got 4 rebounds in the game. Here's Houston. Sinks it from distance.
Such an effective shooter. If you lose track of him defensively, he's gonna make you pay.
Here's Bogues. There's the three. They get it again. Here's Oakley. And they converted last on attempt number three. And the Raptors lead by nine.
And why go away from attacking inside if the D has no answer for you?
Now a timeout called by New York. Carter, he's checked in for Toronto.
Coming onto the floor for your Raptors, Vince Carter.
Outside Johnson. To the wing, right side. Shot clock at five. And the basket is good. Johnson's got six.
Can't talk enough about the subtleties in that setup right there. The assist, really the key to that entire sequence.
And you've got to be in awe of incredible defensive efforts like this.
Oh, showing no signs of giving up this lead. That block sent shockwaves into the opposition sails.
It's stolen. Pass to Bogues. Here's Willis. Hey, hangs it midair and converts the double clutch layup. 6 points for him.
Their intensity has only picked up this quarter, even while holding the lead.
Blocked! Here's Ward. 6 points for him. Houston can't hit.
And they've just built this lead by attacking the boards.
Here's Carter. And it's slammed in by Carter.
You're only two players in the league. You can hit a teammate like that in stride. Beautiful assist.
Pass to Houston, fires the three, drains the triple.
Yeah, he couldn't connect on anything from outside in the first quarter, but now he's hit two threes in the second quarter, and he looks much better.
And Ward pulls it down.
Gotta appreciate the aggressive defense he brings.
Well, it's about the defensive end, and that's what guys feed off. He gives the effort down there at all times.
Here's McGrady. He's got nine. Second chance shot, and he takes it up and lays it in.
They're winning the battle down low by imposing their will.
Here's Ward. Pass to Houston. Down low. Here's Thomas, and he dunks it. What a pass to set him up.
Leaping ability is off the charts. Not the biggest power forward, but outstanding at rising up off the ground.
And Toronto calls time here.
Time for T-shirts.
Making a switch here. Here's Bogues. What? No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Oakley bearing his second of three attempts.
More points coming from inside. In that respect, they've been the more aggressive team.
Here's Ward. Outside Johnson. And denied. He sends it right off the glass. Here's Ewing. No good that time. And it's Toronto taking it the other way. Here's McGrady going inside. And he goes in for the dunk.
Wow, that type of finish is just deflating right now for a team that's trying to make a comeback. Ouch.
That's certainly a big-time finish right there. It was one big exclamation point, or maybe even a question mark. A remarkable defensive play. The replay showing once again the tenacity on that end.
Amazing indeed. And getting stops like that only encourages him to keep attacking on the offensive end.
Here's McGrady. He's got 13.
And they're plus five on the boards after that rebound.
And here are the Knicks now. A 12-point game. Oh, he picked him clean. To the inside. And that one's good. Bogues.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations. Getting good looks inside throughout the half.
Pass to Camby. Here's Houston. He's checked by Carter. Houston gets the bucket. 10 points for him.
This is not a player who likes to be trailing in any game. That lights a fire.
Here's McGrady. And they get it back. Oakley. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
And I like how they focused on getting high percentage shots, especially after the three balls weren't falling early on.
First team foul. Substitution on the court.
.114 left to play in the second quarter. Outside Johnson. Inside. Ed Ewing gets it to go.
And another great assist. The offense is really clicking now.
And here's Brown for three. No good there. Now the Knicks take it the other way. Here's Johnson. Right wing. Here's Wingate. It's hauled in by the Raptors.
Yikes. Bad miss. He could be more assertive as a finisher inside. He would be so much more effective.
Started out strong from three-point land. Hit two in the first quarter, but he's gone dry since.
Now 5 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Houston can't hit.
Risky strategy here. I mean, shifting their offense more to the outside. We'll see.
Carter from outside. And Camby pulls it down. Here we go. Here's Johnson. Misses in close. And so it's Toronto, now holding a 12-point lead at quarter's end. They put in work down low, getting in close and scoring in bunches. We'll be back in a moment.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey again, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson. Shaq is here. Kenny's here. The first quarter for the Raptors was fairly even. They trailed by as many as 6 points in the first period. The second quarter was all theirs. Major uptick in offensive and defensive intensity as they did their jobs with precision, now sitting on a comfortable 12-point lead at the half. And let's get your thoughts, big fella, on the Raptors.
Well, we know the coaches have a steady start to the night for them. They're not wasting possession. They've built a nice lead. They continue to limit their turnovers. They're going to be tough to beat, Ernie.
And over to Kenny. Your thoughts on the Knicks' first half.
Well, the best way they can get back into this game is to show up their rebound. They need to prevent second-chance points and fight. I mean fight to get their own. If they could do that, this game's still within reach.
And that'll about do it as we get ready for the second half. Let's take it down to Kevin Harlan.
Shout out to my man, Joel.
Joel, what up?
Next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it's been a runaway. Carter from outside, and it's Ewing with a rebound.
You know, he's usually very reliable from out there, but tonight it's just not going down.
And for the Knicks, Davis with a rebound.
You love to see guys challenge one another like that. Advantage to the defense that time.
And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
First team foul. At the line for your Raptors. Vince Carter. Two shots.
That one's off. And he ends up missing both free throws. The Knicks with it. Here's Ward. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line.
At the line for the Knicks, Charlie Ward. One shot.
And the free throw, no good. Here's Bogues. Pass to Oakley. Knocked loose. Here's Bogues. Here's McGrady. Covered by Johnson. McGrady. Good. He's got 15.
And just executing at a high level. I mean, taking what the defense allows and putting in the work.
Basketball IQ is something that gets talked about, but its importance to a team showing up here, running plays that turn into scores.
All five guys are in sync. Their ball movement is flawless.
Here's Carter. And he drops it in from the low post. Carter's got 22.
This is what he gives you night in and night out. Stellar production at the offensive end.
Played it in with a nice touch off the window. And the Raptors lead by 14.
He's got a lot to do with the position that they're in. A very smart offensive performance tonight for him.
Here's Houston. And the three-pointer goes.
He's not the reason that they're trailing in this one. He's been on his game. There's a few of the other guys that need to pick it up.
Here's Carter. Rebounded by Johnson. Johnson's got rebound number 5 here tonight to the paint. The fader. He can't hit that time. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way.
With him struggling tonight, they need to find some other options out there to keep themselves in the game.
Here's McGrady. No good with the triple. And here's New York now. They trail by 11. Pass to Sprewell. Now here's Johnson. Oh, he gets it to fall, and that makes it just a single-digit deficit. Johnson's got 8.
Great use of the bounce pass. Thumbs down on that one. Tough to defend against.
Here's McGrady. The putback. That shot off. And so it's New York with it. Inside. Oh, and he blocks it off the glass. Wow. Jacks up a 3. Good. And he's hit 8 of 14 now. A solid offensive performance.
Trying more and more to utilize the three-pointer. It's a good idea. That's his second 3 of the game. 1 in each half.
And the whistle blows on a backcourt violation. Over and back.
You have to limit mistakes. They're so tough to overcome.
Well, not making things easier on themselves right now, that's for sure.
And a second look at that rejection. Taking no prisoners on defense there.
Yeah, what a play. I mean, that'll have the offense thinking twice about taking shots in his presence.
Curry, he's checked in for Carter. Dudley, he's checked in for New York. Thomas comes in for Johnson. McGrady. And again, Toronto, no good. And here's New York now. A 12-point game. Houston gets the bucket.
That's just a lapse right there. No matter what, somebody has to be there and get a hand up in the shooter's face.
Pass to Oakley. Here's McGrady. Fires the 3. Buries it from 3. 21 points in the game.
That's his 3rd triple of the night. His 2nd since halftime.
The ball's knocked loose. Here's Dudley. Checked by Davis. Here's Thomas. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
That's his 2nd personal foul. 2nd team foul.
And he can't get the first one.
Kurt Thomas taking 2 shots.
And the 2nd free throw is good. Here are the Raptors now. And here's Curry for 3. And the Raptors, another 3.
No way he's going to pass that shot up. The D is way too far back and relaxed and getting out on.
Raptors foul. Del Curry. That's his 1st personal foul. 3rd team foul. Substitution for your Raptors. Kevin Willis. D. Brown.
Here's Ward. Give him 8. The floater. The rebound by Willis.
hard to convert against that kind of defensive pressure.
Those are all the little things about effort there. He just gets out there and contests, and that's just enough.
And here's Brown for three. It's rebounded by Dudley. And here are the Knicks now. They trail by 14. Pass to Ward. And that one goes. He's now recorded his fifth bucket in eight tries.
Disappointing as a player to have such a great game and still be trailing. Not over yet, though.
With the putback. Oh, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. Give him eight.
Great effort to turn the miss into 2 points.
Yes, sir. Those are the hustle points. Here's Thomas. Pass to Ward. Here's Sprewell. 9 points in the game.
That's another just bad decision on a night full of those. His shot selection tonight has been questionable at best.
Nice shot by Christie.
They haven't relied on him as much as usual, but when his number has been called, he shot well enough to help them earn the lead.
Here's Houston. Step back shot. Kept alive. And they're going to count that bucket, and they'll send him to the line. It could be a three-point play.
You don't want to ever give up points on the boards. That's the lesson for the team there. That's a hustle play to save points.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Raptors.
The way they've been chasing after their shots in this game is really admirable. Getting them lots of second chance looks at the basket, too.
Well, something else that has stood out is their up-tempo offense. And these guys have been on the track all game long. They're creating high percentage looks, getting out there on the fast break.
All five of the last buckets they've given up have been from downtown.
Here's Sprewell. He can't get that one to fall. Excellent D there from Davis.
I'll tell you what, they've rebounded the ball tremendously well.
And here's Brown for three. Oh, again, Toronto with a triple.
Man, they're having a hard time defending the triple. That's three in a row.
Pass to Sprewell. Shoots from the elbow, and he hits the jumper.
Well, he's 1 for 5 in the quarter, and his body language is saying a lot about where his confidence is. Rattled just a little bit. Maybe the next open look will start him up.
And they've been able to maintain this lead despite his inconsistency from the field.
Sprewell gets the bucket.
Their spacing isn't quite as good as it was in the first half. They may need to hit more threes to stretch that defense.
Now a timeout called by Toronto.
Let's give Coach credit. He's trying to find a way to squeeze the most out of every possession.
You gotta feel good as a coach if you make all those adjustments. Pull the right strings. That's what they love to do.
Williams has checked in for New York. Boy, this could snowball if they continue to put up points.
I can't say enough about their performance.
And again, Toronto, no good.
That's his shot, and one I'm sure he wants back.
Pass to Houston. The putback. Christie with a rebound. And so here is Toronto. Here's Curry for three. Here's Willis. Shot blocked. And he recovers it. Well, it was only a matter of time before they finally get the bucket. 41 seconds left in the third quarter. Pass to Sprewell. Fires from the wing. And it's New York scoring again.
That's three buckets in a row off assist.
Here's Brown. 10 points for him. Let's go with a three. Can't get it to drop. The Knicks go the other way with it.
This has not been a good quarter right here. Shot has been off the mark, and now it looks, Kevin, like he's pressing a bit.
Here's Ward. Second shot opportunity. Ooh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
15 down. At the line for the Knicks.
And he makes it first. So both teams changing it up here. Good on the second, so he makes them both. We've got 13 seconds left in the third quarter. Carter from outside. The offensive rebound. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
Yeah, and you never want to let shots at the rim go uncontested.
That free throw, no good.
At the line for your Raptors, Kevin.
And he's good on the second. There's 6 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's Sprewell. Misses. And so it's Toronto, up 15 points as this quarter concludes. Well, when you win the battle of turnovers, you typically win the battle of possessions. We'll be right back after this word. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist of the game.
You can count on him to deliver a few assists like this one each and every night.
Sometimes it happens when the offense is struggling, but every now and then this helps with the offensive uptick right there. Great job of setting his teammate up.
And there have been two very different performances from these teams today as we get going in quarter number four. Oh, it's stolen. And for New York, here's Bogues. Had a miss there on the triple.
Well, there's more he could have done in this game for sure, but it hasn't kept them from pulling ahead.
Pass to Sprewell. Puts it up from 12, and he can't bank that one in.
Well, after an impressive first half, he's just not been able to get the room or get anything going here in the second.
Here's McGrady. Off target from three-point range. Here's Johnson. Hey, shooting the ball well. He's 5 for 9 in the game. And what a drive that was. Replay courtesy of Mobile One.
Yeah, they have a long way to go, but attacking the rim like that is a great way to start a comeback.
Pass to McGrady. Here's the three. Pure from three-point range. 24 points for him.
He has been an absolute wrecking ball from outside during this half, guys.
Here's Sprewell. Kick out to Johnson. Here's Dudley. Ooh, plenty of contact on that shot. Officials call the foul, and he'll take two free throws now.
The officials were right on top of that
one. First one falls for him. The Raptors making a switch here. Davis has checked in. That misses, so he splits the free throws. They absolutely want to add to what's already a big lead.
No question, B.A. No reason to let up. Just keep playing your game.
Here's McGrady. No good on the triple. Outside, Johnson. Out to the right wing. Here's Ward. Sweet little floater.
Always fun to look at. Not tremendously efficient, but the floater. Boy, those sure are pretty.
Three-pointer. Drills it from deep.
They've had a hard time shutting down the three-point shot.
Moving along. 2 minutes gone in the fourth. Pass to Houston. Here's Ward. Here's Dudley. Uses the glass on the layup.
Of all the action happening there, it's the assist that jumps out to me there. That's just a great look and a great setup for the bucket.
Here's Christie. Takes the three. And they'll get another chance.
Yeah, maybe a little luck, maybe a little bit of heart. Both of those at play here. He's getting every offense rebound.
They grab their own miss. Count that bucket. Johnson's got 4 points in the quarter.
Have to take care of the defensive boards better than that.
Yeah, you just can't afford to give up second chance opportunities again and again.
And that drops for him. And the Raptors lead by 14. Fourth quarter keeps moving along. 3 minutes gone by now. Outside Johnson. To Camby. And that one is stopped right through.
He may give up a little size, but has to bounce to hold his own.
Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We play about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter here. Here's Ward. Pass to Dudley. Here's Houston. Here's Camby, and it's flushed down.
A nice jam.
They're being put to the test, and he's doing everything he can to keep them in this game.
Here's Christie. Knocks down the triple. And here's New York now. For three. Oh, they get a hand on it. Out of bounds. It'll be Knicks ball.
New York ball. Knicks substitution. Patrick Ewing.
Let's and here are the Knicks now. It's a 13-point game. Pass to Johnson. Oh, that bucket gives him his seventh field goal in 12 tries.
Now they're playing working to perfection there, if that was their plan. And if it wasn't, maybe that should be their plan.
Christie. He buries it from three.
He's putting them to the test this quarter, attacking every chance he gets.
Knocked away. From deep. And the rebound goes to the Knicks. Pass to Ward. Down low. And Ewing gets it to go.
They have no answer defensively inside.
Now a timeout called by Toronto. And we've heard the cautionary tales in the past. Does it seem like players today are getting better financial advice, in your opinion, Grant, to make their money last?
Yeah, B.A., I think they're getting better financial advice, but I also think that the times that we're in, I think there's more awareness. Players understand the pitfalls or potential setbacks, the social media, digital age, all the information's there. So players today, yes, they're making more money, and I actually think they're doing a better job of protecting and saving their money, too.
And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Thanks, guys. Toronto's head coach had some words for his team over the break. He likes what he's seeing, but he cautioned his players, we are not far enough ahead to assume anything. Momentum can shift in a heartbeat. We have to be diligent, and we have to be smart.
Okay, thanks, Allie. Here's Sprewell. And the bucket is good.
Very little resistance around the rim right now. That's the fifth straight bucket they've given up in the paint.
Pass to McGrady. This one for three. Connects from downtown. He's got 27.
When this guy starts hitting threes, watch out. He's just pouring it on this half.
Raptors lead by 15. And a bit of a battle for the ball. And the officials signal a jump ball here. So it's Toronto now. Poke loose. Pass to Sprewell. Deflected. And they recover it. Here's McGrady. Four, three. And the Raptors, another three.
And their strategy is obvious. Manufactured looks from outside the arc.
And I don't know how they keep doing this, but every time down, the resulting possession ends up at the three-point line and a fairly efficient shot attempt at that. Oh, can't punish the defense for leaving him open that time. That's a frustrating miss for a really steady jump shooter.
With that offensive board, they're likely to have the last possession here.
Can't throw down the putback. Will it go? Houston gets the bucket.
Allen Houston.
A minute 29 left in the final quarter. Pass to McGrady. Fires for three. Gets the three to fall.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
Yeah, pretty infectious right here. Guys in good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
A new lineup here for New York.
Substitution on the court.
Here's Wingate. Williams defending. Here's Smith. And the layup falls.
That's the kind of passing you want there. Work the ball around, keep it moving, try to get an assist on every bucket.
The three from Curry. Rebounded by Johnson. And the Knicks with the possession here. Here's Smith. Williams grabs the board. They are blowing this one open.
Maybe the only question is how big will this lead grow?
Here's Thomas. Three-pointer, no good. To the middle. Here's Smith. Nice assist and nice finish. Solid play all the way around.
Now catching the lead pass at full speed. Terrific anticipation. And the delivery on time, on target.
Great job of closing the space and getting a hand up.
Yeah, as good as you can do without getting a block there to defend.
The shot by Johnson, no good. Now the Raptors with it. The lead is 15. From the arc. And that one's good. Workman.
Haywood, Workman.
11 seconds left in the fourth quarter here. Here's Wingate. So it's the Raptors winning this one easily. Well, this might not have been the most competitive game we've ever seen, but you've got to appreciate their masterful performance.
And I'm sure their fans appreciated it, too. We saw the outstanding defense and a loaded offensive effort. And they were just dominant out there.
And that about does it for the first game of the new NBA season. So alongside Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, Brent Berry, and our entire 2K crew, I'm Brian Anderson saying thank you for watching. So long, everybody.